Alrighty, well, today I'm gonna make jellyfish ramen noodles. And I've had these jellyfish for a while now. But I reckon they're still good. I got them from the Chinese grocery store near me here. So I'm gonna see what happens when I make them with some ramen noodles. Here's the other part of things, the Maruchan Oriental flavor ramen noodle. Here, that's probably a pretty good flavor for this purposes. So now I'm pouring in the broken up ramen noodles into the bowl. Take out the flavoring. This is what the jellyfish itself looks like. I don't know if you can see it too well, but, you know, there you go. They're kind of, I know my brother described them as sort of like rubber bands. So, and they do have sort of a maybe rubber band texture. So, if you like eating rubber bands, then jellyfish is probably your cup of tea. And jellyfish usually also come with these instant jellyfish. You can actually eat these right out of the bag if you wanted, but I'm going to be cooking them briefly. But they usually come with some sort of seasoning. I'm not sure what kind this is, because I'm not. My Chinese is a little bit on the rusty side. So now I'm going to microwave the jellyfish, or I mean not the jellyfish, just the ramen noodles for about 2 minutes. And then after that, then I'll throw in the jellyfish and microwave them for a wee bit, along with the ramen. This is very exciting, I know. Let's see if we can zoom in. So you watch the ramen being cooked. There's the mice. They like their matzo ball jar. They're kind of sleepy right now. And they also like pasta boxes. You can see I have their wheel out because it was noisy. Here it is outside. It's kind of colder today, actually. Cloudy out. I guess a storm's coming in or something. I don't know exactly. Here's a Monet I bought from one of my friends. It's not a original Monet, but. Well, the first part of the ramen's done, so let's throw in the ramen. Okay, now I'm gonna dump the jellyfish in there with the ramen like that. It'll be nice when they invent cameras that can record smells, because then you could smell with the jellyfish, but I don't know, I don't think they've gotten there with the technology just yet. Okay, so here we go again. Just gonna cook it for 30 seconds with the jellyfish in there. So, yep, wicked. Here you can see my, this is some of my nephew's artwork. Not really sure what this is. Let's cut it open, because I could either use this or the ramen flavor, or both perhaps. So let's do some taste testing. I think this is like sesame seed oil or something. Maybe I'll Might as well throw this in, I guess. Why not? So yeah, here we go. Putting in the sesame seed oil, I guess. I think that's what this is. Could have... Yeah, I guess that's what it is. This also seems to be some sort of sesame seed doings as well. I don't know. And maybe peanuts. Hint of peanuts or something. Maybe it's... I don't know what's going on here. But yeah, I'll just sprinkle a little bit in. Just to play it safe, I think I'm going to add this in so I know that I'm going to get my daily sodium, you know. Always good to make sure you get enough sodium every day and whatnot, so. There we go. It's a little easier to do this sort of thing with two hands. Mix it all up. Not sure how. Maybe I'll just set the thing on the camera and then I'll, or the camera on the counter. Once I'm wealthier, then, you know, I could get like a cameraman or woman. It's not too bad. I think I like it better than when I made it just by itself last time. The jellyfish isn't really that flavorful. It's mostly just like a texture thing, I guess. Just like my brother said, kind of like a rubber band. So whatever else you put on it, you know, whatnot. Alrighty, folks. Well, it's been fun. Hopefully you'll enjoy this and maybe you'll feel inspired to go get some instant jellyfish and ramen noodles and have some fun. Cheers and greets.